winter, but it's spring. Welcome to our spring concert. I am Miss Sanford. Behind me is the Wind Ensemble. The number we just played for you is entitled Mambo. It's from West Side Story. We did have one soloist in that song. Brandon Burns, could you stand up, please? All right. Our next number we have for you this evening is entitled To This Heartbeat, There Is No End. And this song, much like the Dixieland piece we played for you at our winter concert, our real winter concert, it was chosen because we went to New Orleans this past winter with the band and the chorus, and we had a wonderful time. It was really great to see different cultures, see the history of a different area of our country. But one of the really cool parts, and I think the kids will agree with me, was getting to know some of the people that were down there. Most importantly, or most particularly in this story that I'm about to tell, our bus driver, Miss Renee. She was wonderful. She was easily one of the most kind people that we've ever met. She was always very friendly, always greeted the kids with a smile. And yeah, she was wonderful, wasn't she, guys? She drove us around the city to all of our destinations. And what was really neat about Renee is a lot of times bus drivers, they'll just take you to point A to point B. They're doing their job, essentially. But a lot of times they won't speak to you. Renee would always talk to us. And everywhere that we went, she would tell us a little bit about the area. She was born and raised in New Orleans. And like most people that were born and raised in New Orleans and were in New Orleans in the early 2000s, she lived through Hurricane Katrina. So as we traveled in and around the city, she would point out different areas. This was the path where her and her husband, this is the route they took to evacuate the city. This area was flooded and completely destroyed, and now they've rebuilt it. Here is the Superdome, where she had a friend that she was went to high school with and was there and stranded there for days after the hurricane. And of course, for us, being from the Toms River community and the Jersey Shore, we could relate to that because we had gone through Hurricane Sandy. This next piece, To This Heartbeat Is No, There Is No End, is a tribute of sorts to the people that survived and then also didn't survive, tragically, Hurricane Katrina. I want to read a little bit that the conductor wrote in the program notes of my score, just so you know what to listen for and some of the things that you're going to be hearing musically, why it's done. I remember reading this when I first received this score. I was sitting out at a hall duty over there in the hallway and reading, and just like tears were coming down my face, and I was getting very emotional because I was listening to the recording and understanding what the composer was intending as he had all these musical lines coming out. And I was like hoping that nobody was walking by as I'm sitting there crying by myself at that desk in the hallway. Let's see, what does he say? Even though there is no way to truly understand what those folks living on the Gulf Coast went through during the catastrophe of Hurricane Katrina, this piece is a tribute to all who continue to persevere in the aftermath. I am grateful to the group that has commissioned this piece. The timpani part, which will be played by Miss Erin McGuire, who is not in band class. She's joining us to be our heartbeat. So the timpani part, although repetitive, is the most important part of the story. This is the heartbeat of the Gulf Coast community that would not die no matter what tragedies came along. The piano, played over here by Miss Kaylee. We don't have a harp player, but the crotales and bells, played over here by Vinny and Riza, is the representation of the cell phones that many held in their hands after the storm passed, waiting for the ring to let them know that another loved one had survived. The triad arpeggio, first sounded by the oboe, over here, Ms. Maisie Salt, and then followed a little bit later by Ms. Tiffany Pyers on the French horn, represents the cry for help that so many heard as they searched for survivors after the storm. So the entire piece, as you're hearing these different lines played by these different musicians, they're meant to represent something. And the overall, just like when we had that piece commissioned several years ago to kind of commemorate our perseverance as a community to get through and recover from Hurricane Sandy, this piece is very similar, and that it's written to kind of show that in this music, through music, and kind of a tribute to the people of New Orleans. So hopefully you enjoy our rendition of it. It's a very emotional piece. I like it. I think these guys like performing it. Here is To This Heartbeat, There Is No End. Thank you. have a few soloists for that. Maisie, stand up. Tiffany, stand up. Pam, stand up. Alyssa, stand up. And of course, Erin Arhoffi. Thank you, Erin. All right, so the next number, I do need to give the profession a little bit of time to set up, so I will talk. I bet you weren't expecting to hear as much of me tonight. But I do want to recognize a few people. As you see in your program, there are little notes next to all of our graduating seniors. We'll talk more about them in a little bit. I do want to draw our attention to two of our graduating seniors because we're really proud of them, and they are two seniors that are going for music. So Pam and Maisie, could you stand back up? They've come really, really far since day one as far as musicians and actually as people too. I mean, we're sending them off into the world as great representatives of Tom's River East Music Department, so I wanted to recognize them as well. You guys can take a seat. They're awesome. And then I also want to recognize somebody who's totally not about to expect this, but this is this gentleman behind me. His name is Zach. Zach has only been in band for a year. Go ahead, clap for Zach. I wish we could build a time machine and go back in time and get him to join us a lot sooner. We are really appreciative. I love having him here. He's fun. He's a really good musician. And obviously the best way to show him that is by leaving him out of the program not once but twice. That is 100% my fault, Zach. So I apologize for that. You are wonderful, and I promise this time, get you a pretty yellow program with your name actually printed in it. We're not actually used to having a bass player in concert band, so it's awesome that he's here and doing that. So we do love him, and I'm terrible, so I apologize for that. The last number that the wind ensemble, go ahead and clap. The last number that the wind ensemble has for you tonight, while it's certainly, as you can probably guess from the title, a fun-sounding piece, it is actually very difficult. It's a grade 5, which is pretty much as hard as it gets for concert band music for high school students. They kind of proved me wrong a little bit with this piece. I gave it to them and I was like, yeah, we're not actually going to do this. And then I took it away. And then enough of them spoke to me and convinced me to give this back to them. The piece is based on cartoon music, so what you might hear when you're watching a children's cartoon. If you look in the back, the percussion is frantically leaning over a bunch of different non-traditional instruments, so to speak. So keep your ears tuned to what they're doing in the back there. There is quite a bit happening. Actually, I can say there's probably like at least 4 instruments, and I'll use air quotes on the word instruments, that have never really been performed on high school stage before. So that's kind of cool. Hopefully you enjoy our rendition of Tuneful Tune. Thank you.
That was just as a workout for me as it is for them, I promise. We did have some soloists during that song. Oh my gosh. I'm Mr. Miller. If you don't know me, I'm the assistant band director here at the school. This is my first year teaching and my second concert. These kids are wonderful. It's a blessing to have for my first year. So like I was saying, are a couple, two soloists. We have James and we have Melissa. Stand up. They solo together. So we need, right? Thank you guys so much. This is the symphonic band here at High School East. We represent every single band student. So if you're in wind ensemble, you're also in symphonic band. The biggest group that we have here currently at school, the biggest musical group, all right? We have, yes, our second number will be selections from the Broadway play, Phantom of the Opera. This year, Phantom of the Opera is celebrating 30 years on Broadway this year. So, what better time of year, what better year to play this arrangement than right now? Andrew Lloyd Webber, wonderful composer, as you will listen through all these selections. If you haven't seen the Broadway play, I know it's a movie now. I recommend you go see it. It's very well put together. It's a very great love story and drama all at the same time. So without any further ado from me, I'll let the kids do the talking. Here we go.
Thank you.
for a soloist on that one. Chris on baritone horn. Joseph Sasso on the trumpet. Maisie Salt on the oboe. And I'm going to give a shout out to my entire low brass. Please all stand up. Yes, their solely for Angel of Music was wonderful. One more round of applause for the symphonic band. We're going to close out with a little number called Uncharted Galaxy. It is an oldie but a goodie. I found it digging through the school library, the school music library here, and I could only find a recording, not via Google, not via Spotify, not via YouTube. I had to go to a publishing company that is not so popular anymore. More of the recent publishing companies did not carry this song in their library anymore. That's how old it is. I'll let you take a guess on how old it is later. Come up to me later, all right? So, before we do that, I have to introduce to you the motif used throughout this piece that caught my ear instantly. The composer used 5 notes, and he made an entire arrangement. Of course, different harmonic progression, but the same 5 notes throughout his melody, and he twists and he turns it. It turns into a beautiful masterpiece. I actually am gonna have the trumpet ones play at measure 35. I know it's a curveball for you guys, but 35, cool. That's it. 5 notes. I did conduct it a little fast on their part. I give them credit, but I just wanted to get through it. So, those 5 notes, some of them were repetitive, but still only four or five pitches used. Now, you can hear that melody being thrown around the different sections of the band, all right? So tune your ear to that familiar melody as we play Uncharted Galaxy.
Thank you.
recognize some more soloists. First off, we have Kaylee on piano back there. We have James once again on bass clarinet. Rachel on clarinet. Global clarinet. Jake on alto saxophone. And Maisie Salt on oboe. Again. Let's give another round of applause for the Terms of East Symphonic Band. Stay tuned, we have another surprise for you coming up.
Here at High School East, where we perform for our final song of the, oh, actually, hold on for a second. Seniors, can you please stand? Can we cheer for them? Seniors, please remain standing. The percussionists are going to place some chairs out while I'm speaking to the audience. So about 10 years ago, we started this tradition where we play for our final piece for the spring concert. Everybody else though, shh. Very easily distracted. Our final piece, we play Irish Tune from County Derry. More commonly, the melody for that would be Danny Boy. And it's also the melody for our alma mater for here for High School East. It's an appropriate song, it's the last song that our seniors will play with us as Toms River High School East band members. It's very appropriate because as they approach the band room, probably their first time approaching the band room, they'll see that melody painted on the walls of Sea Wing as they head towards the band room. And it is the last thing that they will play with us as members of the Toms River High School East Raider Band. And what we, I know, it's emotional, I know. What we like to do for this last number. Alex, do you have a chair? Poor Alex Rogers. Rise is saving. Saving the day. There we go. All right. What we like to do for this last performance, their last performance as musicians in the Toms River School District, as performers on this stage, we'd like to invite the parents of the senior students up here to sit next to them as they perform their final song. And again, that's kind of appropriate because you guys are the people that started them out playing music. You supported them, you purchased their instrument or rented their instrument. You've driven them to rehearsals and to performances. You suffered through those beginning band days and my neighbors learning to play clarinet, so I am right there with you, it's painful. For some people more than others. And you stuck through them and continue to push them and helped also to mold them into who they are here on the stage right now. So I would like senior parents, if there's a senior parent for each student or family member, I know that the kids have worked this out, please come up to the stage, watch your step, of course, and join your student. another round of applause for our seniors and these wonderful people behind me. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. Thank you so much for your constant support, and we love you guys, and have a great night.